Hey Kids Crossing, welcome to Easter Eggs. That's our new series all about Easter. Now, my name's Mr. Eddie, and I'm excited to join you here today. Izzy, did you catch what I did there? And the reason I'm excited, because here in a little while, we get to go on a giant Easter egg hunt. But also too, stick around to the very end, and we're gonna have another giveaway like we did last week. Now, if you're new here, you can get in on that. All you have to do is text your name and new to the number that's on the screen now. Now, before we get started with all this, let's talk to God. Everybody bow their heads. Dear God, thank you so much for allowing us to join here today. Dear Lord, thank you so much for the many blessings that you give us. Thank you so much for the love that you show us each and every day. And I pray that we'll understand what you're trying to teach us today. And in Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, boys and girls, I was expecting to find a clue here, but do y'all see a clue around here? I don't see a clue. So I need to look around the park a little bit and see if I can find a clue. But y'all go sing about who Easter is all about, and that's Jesus, right? And I'll meet you back here in a few. Boys and girls, look what I found. I think I found our clue. This has got to be our clue, right? It's got to be in one of these eggs. Nothing there. Nothing in that one. Maybe it's that one. Nothing in that one. Ooh, do you hear that? I think it's a clue. Oh, it's just a lifesaver. Could this be our clue? Or somebody think I really like lifesavers and really like Easter candy. But I think it's our clue. So lifesaver, Jesus, Easter. How are they connected? I don't know. Let's watch our video and see if we can find out.
God's story, preparing for Jesus. So part of God's story is about how he prepared us for Jesus, and it begins like this. Remember when God created a perfect garden? He then created a perfect family, Adam and Eve, to live in the garden with him forever. He trusted them with life as long as they obeyed one rule. Unfortunately, Adam and Eve didn't trust God, and they disobeyed. Now Adam, Eve, everyone would have to die, separating us from God forever. This made God very sad, but he had a plan. He knew that he could still save his people through a great rescue, Jesus. Jesus was a big deal, and just like any big deal, people had to get ready for him. It's like before a big movie comes out, you watch the previews so you know what's coming. Well, Jesus was such a big deal that his previews started thousands of years before he came. The first preview is about a man named Abraham. God promised to make Abraham the father of God's special family. God gave Abraham one special son to start the family, Isaac. Now Abraham knew that one day he would have to die because of what happened in the garden. Every time Abraham did something wrong, God could have said, "Okay, because you've done this bad thing, you now have to die." But he didn't. Instead, God said, "How about killing a lamb instead? It can die so you don't have to." "Thank you," said Abraham. But one day, God asked Abraham to do something different. God said, "Okay, because you've done this bad thing, your son Isaac has to die." This made Abraham very sad. But he decided to trust him anyway, even though this meant that he would never have the giant family God had promised. When Isaac asked where the sacrifice was, Abraham said, "God will provide it." And guess what? He did! A ram died so Isaac didn't have to. The second preview happened hundreds of years later. Abraham's family, the Israelites, had gotten huge, but they were stuck as slaves in Egypt under a mean king called Pharaoh. He would not let the Israelites leave, so God said, "Okay, because Pharaoh has done this bad thing, every firstborn son in the land of Egypt has to die." The bad news was, this meant that the Israelite sons would have to die along with the Egyptian sons. But the good news was, God, once again, created a rescue plan. God said, "Anyone who kills a lamb and paints the blood on their door will be saved. The destroyer will pass over your house." The lambs died so the sons didn't have to. Over and over again, when there was trouble, God sent a sheep to die so his people didn't have to. Until finally, God revealed his final rescue plan. The previews were over. It was time for the feature presentation. At last, Jesus, the rescuer, came. He lived on earth just like us, but then he died to take away the punishment we deserved. Jesus died so we don't have to. But guess what else? Jesus didn't stay dead like the sheep. He came back to life and went up to heaven. Now we can be close to God again. And one day, he'll recreate a perfect world for God's whole family to live in forever. Just like the original garden, but better. And that's the story of how God prepared us for Jesus. So in case you missed it, here's the quick version. Death separated us from God. God planned a great rescue. He gave us previews. A ram died so Isaac didn't have to. Lambs died so the Israelite sons didn't have to. Finally, Jesus died so we don't have to. But Jesus came back to life. Now death can't separate us from God. And that's a part of God's story.
Ooh-wee! Some of those things in that video are hard to understand, right, Kids Crossing? They're not only hard for kids to understand, they're also hard for us adults to understand. So why don't Mr. Eddie give his quick version and see if I can simplify it for you a little bit. Let's see. God created the perfect world. God created the perfect people. Well, the two people, Adam and Eve, they did something that God didn't agree with, and that's sin. And it brought sin into the world. Now the world's no longer perfect. People are no longer perfect. And that separates us from God. And that's in the video talking about death. That's the separation they're talking about. Everybody say separate. So that's what happened when sin came into the world. So now God had the perfect plan. And part of that plan included animals. But that was just a preview for Jesus to come. You see, Jesus came and lived the perfect life. He died on the cross and paid something that we owe for sin that separated us from God. right? And then he rose again. You say, Mr. Eddie, you lost me right there. I don't understand that. I don't quite believe that sort of thing. But what if I told you I have some proof? And our proof is actually in the Bible. And we're going to find that proof in 1 John. It's not the Gospel of John, but 1 John. And 1 John is toward the very, very end of the Bible. It goes from Revelations, Jude, then all the little Johns. So go grab your Bible. Hit pause if you have to. Grab your Bible, and we're going to read this verse here in a minute. But let me tell you about John. Everybody know who John is? You don't? Well, John was a close friend of Jesus. He was a disciple of Jesus. So he saw everything Jesus did. He saw all of his miracles. He saw the perfect life that he lived. Do you know what John's job was before he became a follower of Jesus, before he became a disciple? That's right. He was a fisherman. So I'm going to grab my fishing hat already, actually, because Mr. Eddie, he likes to go fishing too. I'm just not very good at it. So if you have your Bibles, let's read 1 John chapter 4. So that's the big number 4 and verse 14. That's a little bitty 14. And we have seen and testify that the Father has sent his Son, and that's Jesus, to be the Savior of the world. All right, boys and girls, there's a couple words in that verse that maybe you don't understand what they mean. So let's have some fun with this, and we'll use our imagination. So the first word is testify. Everybody say testify. So testify is a word like when you go fishing with your dad, right? And say, a lot of dads will go fishing, and they'll catch a fish, and that fish is actually that big, right? But by the time they get home and tell your mama the story about catching that fish has grown to that big. It's a fish tale, right? But one day you do go fishing with your dad, and your dad just hooks up to a great big old fish, right? And you see him reeling it in, and you see him get it on shore, and that thing is so big you're having to help him pick it up, and it's actually that big. So you get home and your dad starts telling your mom the story, and your mom says, I'm sure that fish is really that big, But you then tell her, say, no, mama, I was right there. I saw him reel that fish in, and I saw that it was actually that big. So I testify because I saw with my own eyes what happened, and I tell you the truth about it. That's what testify means. So remember that word, okay? Because you may use it here in a little bit. Okay, the second word is Savior, and it's kind of like what it says. It's to save. Well, Jesus is our Savior. He came here to save us from our sins, okay? Now what I need you to do is, need to get your imaginary hat on, okay? Because we're going out on a boat ride. We're going to go out in the lake, and Miss Manny is going to captain our boat for us, okay? So grab some sunscreen, because I don't want to get in trouble with your mamas, because you got that imaginary sunburn, okay? So are you ready to go? Grab your fishing poles. So now we're out in the boat, and it's a beautiful day, right? All right, let's throw out a line. Nice cast, Tommy. Nice cast. Ooh, I got a fish on. Ooh, do y'all see that, boys and girls? The clouds are getting a little bit darker. Ooh, I better get this fish in. And it's a big fish. Let me let him go. Ooh, do you see that lightning? Do you hear that thunder? The wind is starting to pick up, boys and girls. You feel it? The boat's starting to rock. It's really starting to rock, boys and girls. Oh, here comes a big wave. Get down. Get down. I'm in the water. I'm in the water. And the boat's getting further and further away. Maybe I can swim back to the boat. I'm trying hard and hard. I can't get there. Maybe my dog paddle. I got a world-class dog paddle. I'll get back to that boat. But I'm not getting there. I'm going to tread water. Because the boat's so far away. So far away. What am I going to do? Manny, I need some help. Hey, Manny, I need some help. Can you throw me something? It's a lifesaver. Now, I'm just going to get all the way back to the boat. I don't have to do anything. I'm going all the way back to the boat. Woo! I'm back in the boat. So what does that have to do with being a savior? And Jesus being our Savior. If you think about it, boat being God, the storm being our sins, and that sin separated us from the boat, separated us from God. But Jesus is our lifesaver. I didn't have to work to get back to that boat with this lifesaver. No matter how good I am, I can't swim hard enough. I can't do enough good things to get back to God. Only Jesus gets us back to God. See, boys and girls, God wants to have a relationship with each and every one of us. That's why he sent his son, Jesus, to save us, because he loves us. You say, Mr. Eddie, I want to get back to the boat. I want to get back to God. How do I do that? All you have to do is say, God, I sin. I do things that are wrong all the time. But I ask for your forgiveness, and I believe that Jesus is my life saver, that he came back and died on the cross for my sins, and he rose again. And I truly believe that. And I'm going to do my very best to follow your way, God. Not my way, but your way. Boys and girls, if you prayed that prayer before recently, or maybe after the video, go to your room and sit quietly and talk to God and ask him that. Or talk with your parents about that. You say, Mr. Eddie, I'm still not sure about all this. Text us. Ask us these questions. Keep praying. Keep reading the Bible. Keep coming to Kids Crossing. And hopefully one day you will have that understanding. You will get that relationship with the life saver. Now, boys and girls, are you ready to go find that giant egg that I told you about earlier? All right, let's go. All right, who's ready to find the giant egg? Should we go that way? All right, let's go look. That's not a giant egg. Maybe we need to go that way. That's not a giant egg either. Where is it, Kids Crossing? What? It's behind me? Back this way? All right, let me look. There it is. Ooh, we got something special inside. Let's see what it is. Lifesavers. It's Lifesavers. So if you guys want to win this on the drawing, this is what I need you to do. Do you remember the word I talked about that meant you were an eyewitness and you could tell the story and it begins with a T? Text that name to the what's on the screen, to the number on the screen, so maybe you can win some Lifesavers, because Jesus is our Lifesaver. Remember that. All right, boys and girls, that's all the time we have for today, and we'll see you next week. I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my turn till I made. I was breathing but not alive. All my failures I tried. It was my turn, yeah. Till I made you call my name, and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness into your glorious day. You call my
your story. Come on, listen.
I need a rescue. My sin was heavy, but chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter. I was an orphan. Now you call me a citizen of heaven. Whoa!